In our last video, we collected and prepared our data for a customer cohort analysis, an approach to analysis that is the single best way to improve a business's acquisition and retention rates. Now, with that hard work out of the way, we're going to have some fun as we build and interpret our cohort analysis in a spreadsheet today on Art Science. Hey there, I'm Kevin Hartman, Associate Professor at the University of Notre Dame and founder of the Art+Science Analytics Institute, where our mission is to make you a better data analyst. In part one of this two-video sequence, we kicked off our cohort analysis by collecting the two pieces of data that we need to conduct a customer cohort analysis. That is the unique customer ID and a transaction date, and then processing those data so that they were ready for analysis. Our processing steps involved converting our transaction dates to week, month, and quarter transaction periods, finding our customer's acquisition date, that day that they made their first purchase with the company, and then converting that acquisition date into week, month, and quarter acquisition cohorts. If you haven't seen that video, you can click the link here or here. I haven't done this yet, so I'm not sure which one it's going to be on. But click that link to watch that video before you watch this one. Now we will use that prepared data set to build the cohort analysis framework. Once we have that framework in place, we'll dive into the data, we'll look for patterns, and we'll decide what they mean for our business. As a reminder, cohorts refer to groups of customers who share a specific characteristic, commonly something time-bound, like the time period in which they made their first purchase, or some kind of event that made them your customer, like a sale or an offer. The purpose of a cohort analysis is to track behavior of those groups of customers over time. In this video, we will cover how to build a customer cohort chart using a pivot table in a spreadsheet, key measures we analyze in a cohort analysis, and then my top five ways to use a cohort analysis to drive value for a business. With process data in hand, building a cohort analysis framework known as a customer cohort chart or a C3 could not be simpler. We will simply use the spreadsheet's pivot table function to get that done. A pivot table is a tremendously powerful analysis tool inside of a spreadsheet. We briefly covered pivot tables in the last video of our spreadsheet fundamentals series, which focused on data visualization. We'll put a link here so that you can watch that one as well. For our cohort analysis, we will simply use the pivot table to organize the data we've collected along two dimensions, transaction period and acquisition period. With that framework in place, we'll count the number of customers in each acquisition cohort to see how many of them purchase in each subsequent transaction period. Let's jump into the spreadsheet now to show you how easy it is to get this done. And even though this is a really straightforward task, we've still produced a step-by-step guide linked in the description below so that you can follow along or practice after watching this video. So here I am on my spreadsheet. This is the data that we put together in the previous video. We did all the hard work then. Building the customer cohort chart is really simple from here on out. All I need to do is take this data, use a pivot table to summarize it in a way that's going to put transaction period along the column headers, cohort, acquisition cohort down the rows, and then I'm going to populate the cells with a count of each unique customer ID that I find in those cells to see how many customers bought from each acquisition cohort in those transaction periods. So basically, I'm inserting a pivot table. I'm going to do that into a new sheet. And then using the data that I have available, the decision I need to make is, do I do this on a weekly basis, a monthly basis, a quarterly basis? You need to make that decision for your business. If you are a company that operates with a quarterly renewal, like a SaaS company might for quite frequently, then yeah, analyzing your customers on a quarterly basis makes sense. If you are a company that there is no subscription and customers are coming in frequently, sometimes multiple times a week, might be a grocery store, might be a convenience store, then yeah, the weekly analysis makes sense for you. The cadence that makes the sense most sense for most businesses is to look at this data on a monthly basis. So that's what I'm going to do. Even though we gave ourselves the view of weekly and quarterly, yeah, we can analyze those as well, but let me show you how you build the cohort from a monthly basis. Basically, all I do is I grab that month cadence. I'm going to drop that into the columns. Now I've got the 12 months across the top. I then take the acquisition month,
I drop that into the rows. Those are my acquisition cohorts. And the last thing I need to do is take customer ID, drop that into the values. Now it's going to default to just counting the number of IDs it sees. That's going to double count customers, right? Because I know there are repeat businesses in this business. So rather than the count, and in this case, count A, since those are alphanumeric, I need to use count unique. That's going to give me the true view of the unique customers in each transaction period from each cohort. And there I'm done. Now I've got my C3. If I zoom out just a little bit so that you can see it a little bit better, there are the 12 months. The acquisition cohorts run down the rows, the periods are along the top. So analyzing this says looking at each cohort across the rows, the diagonal is the acquisition numbers. It's the first number of each cohort. I'm seeing the survival rate then as I move down the rows, how many customers from that initial cohort continue to purchase in the subsequent transaction periods. I aggregate it all up to see how many total customers do I have, and that becomes how I look at retention rate. It's that simple.
Now that we have a C3 built, we're going to analyze three important measures: the survival rate of each acquisition cohort, the pace of our acquisition, and then the overall retention rate of our customers. The survival rate in a cohort analysis refers to the percentage of customers within a cohort that remain active, they continue to purchase over time. It's a measure of customer engagement, and it's critical for understanding how long customers continue to transact with your business after their initial purchase. In our C3, you can track survival rate by looking at each horizontal row, each cohort of customers over time. You begin with the number of customers first acquired in that cohort and then calculate the percent of those customers who make a purchase in each successive transaction period. Acquisition rate refers to the number of customers acquired during a specific period. In cohort analysis, this would be the initial size of each cohort. In our C3, this is the diagonal line representing the customers acquired in each particular cohort. Retention rate measures the percent of customers who make repeat purchases over time. It's calculated by dividing the total number of customers who make purchases in a transaction period by the total number of customers that you had when you started your analysis. In our C3, you track this by aggregating the number of customers in all the cohorts at the bottom of the chart. The analysis of survival rates, acquisition rates, and retention rates helps us identify trends and patterns in customer behavior like seasonal variations, and makes it easier to track important measures like churn and revenue generation. There are some important questions that a cohort analysis based on acquisition cohort can answer. Here are the top five ways I use cohort analysis to help businesses. First is the most obvious, it's just conducting seasonal and trend analysis. Cohort analysis can reveal how acquisition and survival rates are trending over time, as well as how they fluctuate seasonally by comparing cohorts acquired during different times of the year. This can provide you with great insight into the overall health of your business and help you prioritize any issues that you have to address. This analysis can also be very helpful in planning inventory, marketing campaigns, any aspect of your business that is dependent on timing. Number two is identifying high-value customers. Cohort analysis allows you to identify which cohorts generate the most value for you over time. This can be done by adding revenue, profit, or ideally, customer lifetime value generated by each cohort into your analysis. Doing so can guide you in reallocating resources from lower performing cohorts to higher value customers. It can also help you refine customer acquisition strategies so that you can target similar high value customers in your market. Number three is measuring campaign effectiveness. Measuring the effectiveness of specific marketing campaigns or channels by analyzing the acquisition, survival, impact on overall retention, and value of cohorts acquired through different campaigns is a really valuable insight into your business. Number four is tracking changes to customer experience. Cohort analysis can help you track how different groups of users react to new product features or price changes or bug fixes or anything that you're doing at a point in time by looking at the behaviors before that point in time and then comparing that to the behaviors after that point in time. By comparing cohorts based on that point in time, You can gauge the effectiveness of your updates and identify which drive user engagement, which do not, by looking at survival rates, acquisition rates, and overall retention in those two periods. The fifth and final way that I like to use cohort analysis is by forecasting business performance. By analyzing the purchase patterns of different cohorts, you can predict future revenue and other key performance indicators based on your experience with current customer cohorts. This helps you in budgeting and planning, especially for subscription-based businesses, and is the foundational idea behind customer-based corporate valuation, CBCV, an innovative approach to corporate valuation. A good cohort analysis will answer all of these questions, and through those answers, you can use data to enhance customer loyalty, refine your marketing tactics, and boost your profits. Thanks so much for watching. If you haven't already, take a moment and subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share it with anyone who you think is interested in data analytics. Every single week, we are bringing new, exciting, and important videos on data analytics, and we would love to have you there for that journey. Be sure to check out the links in the description below for additional Art+Science resources. Sign up for our newsletter to get exclusive tips, course updates, and more directly in your inbox. Look for our next video, which will explore another tremendously insightful and important customer analysis approach, the recency frequency matrix. Until then, we'll see you in the next video.